الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، a question was asked. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Is there any advice that we can offer some of our Muslim brothers, or maybe it's a particular brother that sells t-shirts that say black businesses matter, like the Black Lives Matter movement? Firstly, normally I wouldn't really discuss these kind of issues and leave that to those brothers who obviously have more knowledge and who are on the ground in those societies. But in general, advice I would say is that advise the brother with gentleness and let him know that it would be better to leave off that and ascribe yourself to Muslim businesses matter, because you don't want to be a part of pushing nationalism or pushing anything that could possibly be against the book and the sunnah. A point also that I think is important is also knowing the condition of the person, of the individual. And that, as the scholars mention, in accordance with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من راى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيد فان لم يستطع فبلسانه فان لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك عدو الايمان رواه مسلم. So this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, in Sahih Muslim, in which he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that whoever sees a munkar, then change it with his hand. If he is unable to do so, then change it with his tongue, speak out against it, meaning, and if he's unable to do that, then change it with his heart, and that's the weakest form of faith, meaning change it with your heart, meaning dislike the munkar or the sinfulness in your heart. And so the scholars mention, one of the things that they mention with regards to this hadith, as far as the many, many fawaid and benefits, one of the things is that it shows us that the munkar and taghayr munkar, that sinfulness is on different levels, and changing sinfulness and the ability, the qudra, to change sinfulness or the istita'a is on different levels. And so what's very important is to know the situation of a particular individual. This is why, even if you were to take this question and ask one of the mashayikh, okay, a qa'ida, which is so important, a hukm ala shay far'an ala tasawwurihi, that a ruling based on something is a part of a ruling on something is to have a correct image of it. So it doesn't mean that, no, that's not a, something is not a munkar in this society and it's a munkar in that society necessarily. That's not what we're saying. But what we're saying is that the scholar needs to know the context. Maybe you're dealing, I don't know anything about this individual you're talking about. This brother could be a new Muslim, for example, and this could maybe scare him from the deen. You say, you talk to him about this, and you come in, he doesn't know anything about aqidah, he doesn't know anything about tawheed or anything about sunnah, and you're starting off with this. Or a brother could be a long-term Muslim. You know, he's a Muslim, but you know he's kind of hard-hearted. He's not going to take it, and it's going to cause a greater harm by doing it. Maybe he's a physical brother. Maybe it's a brother who, so you have to have hikmah, you have to have wisdom in and knowing something about the individual that you're dealing with and how to deal with the munkar. So in this case, maybe it's something, it could scare the person from the religion, or they will definitely not take your advice, especially if you come to them in a hard way. So you want to have knowledge and some wisdom on how you approach the individual and just advise them in general. Just say, hey, you know, it would be better to, you know, promote Islam, because, you know, here, when you talk about Black Lives Matters the Black Businesses Matter, okay, yes, there's a need for Black businesses in those communities, but how does that impact the Muslim, as because we're Muslim? And on top of that, how does that those You know, perhaps amongst those black businesses are those who hate Islam and those who are against Islam in totality or whatever the case may be. So you've got to put it in context for them and show them that, you know, that it would be better. I'm not making a hukum on what they're doing necessarily, but I'm just saying that it would be in general better to close the door to something like that, to selling those kind of t-shirts, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So those are just some things to reflect upon, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilm al-nafiyah, wa rizq al-tayyibah, wa amal al-mutaqabbilin, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.